Thank you. Good evening. Thank you so much for being with us this evening. We are the Seacoast Ensemble. We're glad to be here. Also in conditions in which we're not having to bring shovels or salt. A nice pleasure in December. That opening piece, A Christmas Festival by the great Leroy Anderson, so commonly associated with the Boston Pops and all the wonderful work he did. The next piece, Passacaglia is the title of this piece, but it's also a form of how a piece is built. And so there's a repeated line over here, introduced by the low brass after a brief introduction. And you'll sort of hear that line permeate the piece all the way through. You hear it sometimes smoothly, sometimes loud, sometimes soft, sometimes short. So as the piece goes on, you can, I guess, keep track of how many times the melodic line comes through. So Passacaglia on an old English tale.
Thank you. Thank you.
So, just to give you some information about us, in case you haven't seen us before, Seacoast is an ensemble. We are a community ensemble. We rehearse Tuesday nights in Exeter, but apparently actually it's... So, in January, they'll be rehearsing at the Kittery, Maine, which is cool, because then after that, you can just go shopping. So we rehearse once a week, all summer, winter, fall, spring. We take a month off in August so we can regroup. But other than that, we've been pretty busy throughout the year. So instead of me telling you all the concerts, you can always check us out on seacoastwindensemble.org to learn more about the ensemble, upcoming concerts, and how to schedule a concert with us if that's something you'd like to do for an affair. On our website, you can sign up for our concert notification email list to receive updates about our upcoming concerts and activities. We also have a sign-up sheet on the table in the lobby. Right outside the doors, where you can leave your email address and we'll add it to our mailing list. You can find us on Facebook. So you can find us just about everywhere, where we post about upcoming concerts and pictures of the ensemble performing. Also, in November, we had a fundraiser at Flatbread Pizza in Portsmouth, for a Smith growing up in Indiana. I always joked with this ensemble that no one really can pronounce the places correctly. It's actually Portsmouth. We'd like to thank them, and also in Massachusetts, that city that starts with a W, Worcester. I don't know how you get this far, but I still don't. But we'd like to thank Flatbread for sponsoring us, and thank you, and thank any of you if you attended. And on January 15th, we will begin accepting applications from high school musicians for the Paul Irwin Music Scholarship. Please see our website for more information. So, without any further ado, we'd like to do our next piece, Carol of the Bells. Another great thing about working with this group is members of this ensemble have such a wide range of personal experience and professions. Some of the members are actually professional musicians or music teachers. Some people are enjoying the wonderful life of retirement and do this in their vast amounts of spare time that they have. Other people work all day and then come visit us every Tuesday night for rehearsals from 7 to 9:30. So it's just a wonderful thing to have everybody together once a week to rehearse and then all the performances throughout the year. It's always been a great privilege since I've been with this group. They have a wonderful assistant director who's a very talented musician, director, and a terrific teacher. Has been teaching middle school, I won't say the number of years, but for numerous, we'll just say that. And he does a great job of working with his kids, and they're terrific. So would you please welcome to the podium, sort of, Mr. John Roth.
Thank you.
I have to tell you, we do lots of concerts throughout the year, particularly in the summertime, and I hope that you all continue to see this ensemble throughout the regular concert season, but also in the summer. And a great thing that I've enjoyed about being in this group is that I really don't have to do much at all. I'm the person who starts and stops, but they do all the playing, they do all the work, and also there's a wonderful tour, they take care of all the business, they pay the bills. There's a million things that have to happen just to have one performance or a series of rehearsals for a performance. And so I have to tell you, I can't thank all the members of the ensemble enough, and especially everybody who contributes on the board. So if you could all please help me give them all another big round of applause. Born and raised in Alaska, and in some of the small villages, they have a simple expression, many hands make light work. And I figure this ensemble, there's so many hands doing things, and it makes things happen quite easily. At least, I should say easily for me. So they've done a wonderful job of making my job easy. The next piece is the most wonderful time of the year, because really for me, it is the most wonderful time of the year, getting ready for the holidays. And I have two young children, a two-year-old and a four-year-old. And so this time of year is certainly wonderful, so we hope you enjoy this great tune. Especially appropriate this time of the year as we get ready for not only the holidays, but especially New Year's. And when it gets soft in the trio section, let's see if you can recognize it, and if you want to start singing along, we'd love to hear you.
Throughout the year. Thank you very much, and we hope you enjoy the great sleigh ride.